So, where are you coming from?
Egypt.
Egypt? It's a pretty long flight. Probably not used to the cold weather we get up here.
The cold does not bother me. I'm trained to operate in all conditions.
Operate? You sound like some kind of surgeon.
Pull over up here. I will walk the rest of the way. And I'm not a surgeon.
Then what do you do, I didn't catch your name.
If I told you that, I'd have to kill you.
Sorry, man, I didn't mean to invade your privacy, but the fare's $12.50.
Actually, I've already told you too much.
Taco, what is it?
The Egyptian. He's here.
Hi, papi. It's about time.
Go and get his order ready. I will greet him.
Ah, how are you, mi amigo?
I hope you had a buena flight.
Por favor, come in. Your shipment is being prepared this very momento. These materials you asked me to acquire, they were muy hard to get. Everyone asked me, why, Javier? Why do you need these things? So I must ask the same of you, Mr. Barata. What do you plan to do with these materials?
Read the headlines tomorrow morning, and maybe you'll find out.
This is Javier Rodriguez, bomb-making services. Dave, how can I help you? All right, you want plastic or TNT? All right. Say, pal, can I put you on hold for a sec? Thanks, appreciate it. You must be Mr. Baraki. Got your bomb here. You asked for a plastic bomb, so here you go. It's got a range of, I'd say, about 200 to 300 feet. This here's your detonator. The first button on the right, that's going to be the one that sets it off. The second button over, that's going to be the one that sets the time. So you hit it once, that sets it at 1 minute. You hit it twice, that sets it at two. Bada bing, bada boo. I say tomato, you say tomato. Got it? Now, you said you wanted to blow up stores, so I got you something special. This is kind of a brainchild of mine. I don't know about you, but I really hate kids. So, what I want to do, or what I hope you should do, is place this in a small children's store, put a little dog on you, boom, you don't see the bomb. Am I right? Tomato, tomato. So the little kid, hopefully he picks it up, and then kaboom, the whole place goes up in flames. See what I'm saying?
No, it is late.
Mi amigo, please, accept my hospitality and stay for the night.
No rest for the wicked. Do they not say that in this country?
I will return in the morning. I'm sure you will be hospitable enough to grant me asylum until it is safe to move on. Till then, adios, amigo.
Alright.
Now we'll get some paper. What your state name was?
Senor, I fear we have unleashed a sleeping monster by supplying this man. I fear it will cause much pain and suffering in this town.
Taco, since when have you cared about the pain and suffering of others? You jack cars for a living.
It's a low blow, sir. But still, I feel we should stop what he is up to. We should call the policia.
You idiot! If we call the policia, we are dead men, I tell you. Hombres muertos. Get out of my sight before I kill you.
Hombres muertos. Hombres muertos.
27 believed dead, and hundreds more wounded after an explosion flattened a children's toy store early this morning. Authorities suspect the explosion to be the work of a terrorist cell operating within the U.S., and the director of the FBI has authorized an investigation to find who is responsible.
Well, I went to a dance and wore out my shoes. Oh, this morning, wishing I'd
The Lord saw fit sprinkle gold on this land, and man and his...
Well, I stopped me too, and never place in town. This city life is really bad.
Yeah, I'm a white scum rat. Ah, dadgummit! Last time you cut me off, you suck. Dadgummit! Time to stop at Bojangles. Get me some chicken! Give me some chicken!
Sir, you can't fill up here.
The hell I can't.
Detective McGraw, the chief needs to see in his office right away.
Sure, I'll look nice today, Pam. Can I offer you a donut?
The chief needs to see you right now, and I'm on a diet.
Fast enough, thing. How might I be of service to you, Chief?
Well, it's about time you got here, McGraw. The feds are shoving assignments down my throat.
The bombing, huh?
Yeah, the bombing. They've given us a 48-hour window to start this investigation and to solve it. We need to get going right away.
And I assume you want me to lead this investigation?
Yeah, that's correct, more or less. But I want you to take Mark along with you.
Mark?
I know Mark's a new recruit. But he's gonna need some field training, and I want you to take him along.
With all due respect, sir, I've worked alone for the past 20-some years, and the last thing I need is a new recruit to come along with me. I'm what you call a lone wolf.
Buck, look. I understand it, I get it. And I know how upset you were when Donnie died. And I'm not asking you to make Mark your partner. All I'm asking you is you show him the ropes.
Fair enough. But I ain't showing him anything else.
It's about time that wolf joined the pack.
Must be marked.
Yes, sir. Reporting for duty.
Boy, do I look like your dadgum mama?
No, sir.
Stop calling me, sir. Get in the car. We got ourselves a crime to solve.
Mi amigo, you cleaned up nicely.
It appears you're to be staying here mucho tiempo. You stirred up quite a business, anoche.
Actually, I am no longer in need of your hospitality.
A friend of mine has set up a safe house. I would feel more comfortable staying there.
Where is the safe house? I may transport you.
It belongs to Dory Mapp. The police will never suspect her of harboring me. And I can get there myself, thank you.
Well, then this is adios, amigo. Perhaps some coke to see you on your way.
I prefer Pepsi.
If you tell anybody where I am, I will tear you limb for limb and feast on your organs.
Boy, put your dadgum seatbelt on. So, Mark, got you into law enforcement.
Figured it'd be my best chance of helping improve society.
Oh, well, that was deep, Mark. You know, that was deeper than a dadgum well. Guess a kid like you needs a philosophical reason to get into law enforcement. You know why I joined the force?
Why?
Because it brings me no greater pleasure to bash the face into some dirtbag criminal.
That does sound like fun.
Yeah, after 30-something years, there really ain't no greater joy, boy, I tell you.
So, where are we going?
We got a lead on the suspect involved in the bombing. I believe a man named Javier Rodrigo supplied the bomber, so we're gonna go dig something up.
We're gonna go shake the tree, see what falls out.
Bingo.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Sorry, I don't speak Mexican. Are you Javier Rodrigo?
See? What is this about?
It's about a little incident that happened last night. I think you know which one I'm talking about.
The bombing? If I knew anything, I would have already reported it to the FBI.
Oh, well, ain't that honorable. Something tells me you're lying. So I'm gonna ask you again. What do you know about last night's bombing?
I'll repeat my answer. I know nothing. I'm a simple mechanic.
Oh, and I'm sure these machine guns here help you fix up real nice.
Nothing wrong with a little extra security.
I'll be out with a warrant for your arrest. Let's go. Once you're behind bars, you and I'll really get to know each other.
Taco, make sure they don't leave here alive.
Oh, get down!
Crack rock, little truck, take your jab! Mother, cut the bread!
Taking our jobs? Get going, come on!
They got a sniper!
Take him out, dadgummit!
Boy! Over my shotgun!
I'm a copy murderer! Anthony! Damn it! Communist!
More! Come in! Check your hot shot.
Back at the station after he gets cleared by medical.
No more. This is where we start to take matters into our own hands.
Wait, are you saying...
I'm saying we're gonna force him to talk.
Buck, that's not legal. We could get in huge trouble for that.
Mark, when did you start calling the shots around here? Last time I knew, I was in charge. If you don't like things, you can get out!
Fine. What do you want me to do?
I want you to help me get him into that chair over there. I know you supplied the bomber. Just tell me where he is. This whole little thing will be all over. I'll even let you go for free.
Oh. Stop! I'll tell you.
I'm listening.
His name is Baraki.
He left yesterday to go to a safe house.
Where?
I don't know where. He said he was staying with someone called Dolray Mapp.
And that the police would never find him.
Consider yourself free. Come on, Mark. Gotta get back to HQ. Got a warrant to get ourselves.
Is that all?
Mark, you got those chips? Thought I told you to get barbecue. Sorry, he's just new. You gonna put him on the counter or what?
We got a warrant to search your house for a suspect that we believe is involved in last night's bombing.
I got your warrant, officer. Come and get it.
You got 3 seconds to get out of my way before I blow you and your fat away. Come on. Mark,
Everything's clear. Refrigerator's clear. Microwave's clear. Pantry is A-OK. This window's clear. Hell, the air around us is clear. Water's clear. This cookie containing unit is clear. Safe to say, everything's clear.
All right, well, maybe we should go check the basement.
You boys won't find nothing down there.
We're just gonna check it out to be sure.
No, you boys really don't need to do this. You really don't. No, really, you really don't need to go down here.
Shut your trap, Faye.
There's nothing down here, really.
I said shut it.
You're just wasting your time.
Gadgum, woman, I said shut it.
Oh, God, Buck, come look at this.
Oh, my God, Jesus Christ Almighty in heaven.
It's like you're a sex slave or something.
Don't worry, you pile of crap. I'm arresting you for whatever you've done to this poor creature. Cover. You poor thing. Can't imagine what kind of darn fool things that woman must have done to you. Or how the hell she even managed to catch you, but something's gonna be done about this.
Buck, I need some help over here.
Alright.
How do we get her out of here?
Figure something out, Mark. We'll put this poor thing out of its misery. Miss Story Mapp, you have the right to remain silent, so I suggest you shut the hell up. I gotta say, Mark, you did good today. I'm proud of you. Mighty proud. Now get in the car. Let's go celebrate.
Taking her back to the station?
Not yet, Mark. It's time to celebrate. Gonna get me some tacos!
Mark. Are you gonna eat the rest of that quesadilla?
It's all yours, bud.
Oh. Getting started.
If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. I got the rat patrol on the cat patrol. Foes that want to make sure my cask is closed. Rat critics saves money, cash holes. I'm from the hood, stupid. What type of facts are those? If you grew up with hoes and your zap of toes, you celebrate the minute you was having dope. I'm like, fuck critics, you can kiss my whole asshole. If you don't like my lyrics, you can press fast forward. Got beef with radio, if I don't play they show, they don't play my hits, well I don't give a shit. So, Rap Max trying to use my black ass so advertisers could give them more cash for ads, fuckers. I don't know what you take me as, or understand the intelligence that Jay-Z has. I'm from rags, the richest niggas, I ain't dumb. I got 99.
lost some weight. Who said prison was a bad thing at all? Harlot.
Today we'll be hearing the case of Dulry Mapp versus the state of Ohio. May I begin by calling Dulry Mapp to the stand?
Hope they crucify you, harlot.
Miss Mapp, can you please tell the court what occurred when Detective McGraw searched your house?
Well, they came and they knocked on the door. And they had a fake search warrant. I don't even think it was a real search warrant. And they put a gun up to my tummy, and they forced their way through to my house because they said there were terrorists, but there were no terrorists. And they found my sex slaves, and they arrested me for my sex slaves. But those aren't terrorists, so I don't understand. They can't do that.
No further questions, Miss Mapp.
I would now like to call Detective Barry McGraw to the stand.
What?
It is clear to me your impertinence knows no bounds, Mr. Barry Buck McGraw. Now, tell me, is it true that you searched Miss Delray Mapp's home?
That slob was harboring terrorists. I was just protecting the sanctity of America.
Is it true then, Buck, that you had no warrant to search her home? This fat harlot's home?
Yeah, I had a warrant. Wrote it myself on the way over.
I'm sorry to say this, Buck, but a warrant written with your child's rose art colored pencils and Crayola crayons is hardly a valid warrant at all. All evidence found in the home of Miss Mapp is invalid under the exclusionary rule. And I'm sure you'll find your new position as park ranger quite comfortable.
Dadgum crackpot liberals. You and your hippie hair. Park ranger should be a job for someone like you. Smoking your marijuana, safe in the trees, and can't build cities anymore because of you hippies. I have nothing more to say.
With the powers vested in me by the United States Constitution, written by God in 1776, through the hand of Jesus and the voice of the Holy Spirit, I now declare Delray Mapp a free, white, non-guilty, fat harlot. Go home and tend to your young, nubile, possibly Asian male sex slaves. I imagine they're very hungry. I know I would be.
Communists.
Good, good. Crackpot, literal. Come on!
You guys are laughing at me.
You need to see in his office right away.
Delray Mapp is a free, non-guilty, white harlot.
I was just protecting the sanctity of America.